being asked to notice or to agree?
We're asked to vote, that's the recommendation.
But by all means, Jeffrey, can I ask you a question?
Yes, you can, I would say. Couple of things, really. So, one presumes this is a matter for council, because this has to be the financial and budget and policy framework, as the impact goes on. Is that what this seems to suggest is we are now going to spend the entire council finances to the 20 pledges. Now, when the 20 pledges originally came through, they were perfectly disappointed. They weren't the sole aim of every pound that was raised for council tax. But not in my mind, anyway. So we're talking about quite a potentially significant change to the budget policy framework, unless what goes to tell me this was all in the budget resolution, therefore that was what council agreed. The other thing, I think as people know, I have some real concerns about the various iterations of the income generation strategy, which has led to car parking charges in the parks, in coastal areas, etc., which has, which strikes me as being a small wrong-headed to the whole approach. So, whilst I can notice, I have no doubt at some point that we share and try and get behind some of the what it is that we're trying to achieve, or I've taken a particularly wrong-headed look at what's being intended here, and maybe it's something else. I'm sort of happy to do that. But as I say, I think there are some big issues for the council to address. No one's get sure that it's not responsible for what I've been doing. So I certainly want some opportunity to talk to Cllr about that and to get some an indication of what's actually going on. That's where I still want.
So that wasn't a question.
No, not really. It's more of a statement.
Yes, we are allowed to
state it. If I may, Chair, there was a question in.
Yes, there was.
There was.
I think you were referring to the budget and policy framework.
Yes, I am.
I think the question was going to be shared outside the meeting.
So that was question number two. Question number one was by Cabinet adopting a medium term financial strategy.
Yes,
this document right here, should that be approved by full council as part of the budget policy framework? And the simple answer is no. It is the cabinet's job, their role, to formulate the budget over the year. It is council's role to approve and adopt that budget at the end of the year. There is a specific process for that. This sets out the cabinet's means by which it would go about formulating the budget for next year to put to council for council's approval come next March. In the meantime, it's here to use the audit committee to consider the risk and audit implications of cabinet taking such an approach.
And just as a piece of legal advice, and always happy to be correct, my understanding was that if there is an adjustment the budget policy framework as agreed by council, which this will be, as we talk about taking money out to make it sustainable, to stop doing things is what we are suggesting. If that's done in year, that's a change I will set to the budget policy framework, and that then becomes a matter for the council. But again, more than happy to make it to have a chat with you about some of the details as well.
The answer to that is something that should be quite likely is if this resulted in a decision that was contrary to the budget that has already been adopted, then that would need to go to full council for approval. But that is a particular decision that would be made as a result of this approach. So if this approach resulted in this year in a decision that's contrary to the budget, and Chairman, I would ensure that decision went to full council for
so,
not this
document. Okay. So I don't know whether this document sets up the panel which has Paul's spoken to check each element of discussion we spoke to with 20 pledges, whether that is within any changes to that would be a change to the leadership policy.
So, interestingly, this was tested. So, in the court.
Oh, that's.
So, what the budget does is it sets out the various funds by which the executive have to spend on the various services correlating to those funds. So, that sets a ceiling of what can be spent subject to Parliament. It doesn't require that money to be spent. So if cabinet or office of decisions throughout the year said that we're not spending money, then that would be fine and that would not be contrary to the budget.
Really contrary to policy.
Only if it were directly contrary to a lot of policy on policy framework. And there's now only about four documents on that policy framework because they've shunned the numbers to say no.
Any other questions?